tell me about a time that you've written a song for somebody. Probably the best example that you can give, because I'm sure this happened to you a lot, that you said, like, yo, this is a hit, and somebody turned it down, or just like, nah, and then it ended up going to somebody else. Tell me your probably favorite story about that.
Favorite? It's not really a favorite, because I hate when one song goes from somebody to another person. Mm-hmm. It's just, it is what it is. Like, I think that's more in a spiritual sense of where the song needs to be or where it ends up at, you know. Like, you can't really force something to be somewhere, or at least I try not to. I remember rocking that thing, actually. I wrote that at the time I did, like, Jamie Foxx's album. Which album was this, man?
Unpredictable?
Is it Unpredictable?
Or Intuition, I think.
Intuition, probably. Yeah. It's the one that had the T.I. single on it?
Yeah, Intuition.
Okay, Intuition. And I wrote Rockin' That. Of course, even on that album, I had like 7-8 records on that mm-hmm. album. It was like, okay. Rockin' That, man, you need to do this record. And he was like, I don't know, Dream. And so in my mind at that time, I was like, I know this guy that can sing this record. Like, he said, he got one more time. Like, I always give people another. Like, he got one more time to say, I don't want that record, mm-hmm. profusely. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yo, Jamie, you need to sing. I was like, no, this record, man. He's like, no, I don't want that record, man. I want this other record. Like, all right, cool. And so, of course, I ended up singing Rockin' That. And who would know, like, you know, like, how big culturally the record was. And just for me, period, and for my brand, it was a great record. And at the same time, competing with the record that he had off of his album at the time, which was, God, what was that?
I want to say, was it Digital Girl?
No. It was the big hit off of that album.
Yeah, what's that?
Blame It, which was a sample from I Love Your Girl. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I'm competing with myself, like, with this record, and I'm like, man, you'd have been on fire. Thank God you didn't. I need this record. Appreciate it. Girl, I'm in love with you, baby. And I want you to know that I'm hooked on your body. And I'm trying to be yours. Oh, I remember a friend of mine, Chris Hicks, who signed my first publishing deal over at Warner, and my golf friend. He said, "Yo, I need you on this Justin Bieber album." I'm like, man, y'all always talking shit. I ain't doing nothing. Y'all want me to do something? I know, because y'all have a studio PO, and we'll be talking about something. Other than that, I don't want to hear that shit. Because whenever I start talking about, usually when I start talking about where I'm going to stay or whatever it is, it's like, nobody will tell me, but they talk to my management or whatever. It's like, man, why is this shit so high? Like, why is this hotel bill so high? You know, whatever. But I try to, you know, logically, even for them, I try to make it make sense by not spending like a whole month in the studio to write one fucking record. Like, they may pay whatever that price is to stay at the Plaza, but when they really think about it, they pay for 2 days versus flying their artists around for 8 months trying to find one song. Mm-hmm. The music business is fucking wacky as fuck. So I told them, I say, look, I'll write a song tonight. You just gotta pay for my Plaza hotel for 2 days. I was like, but I got you. And you would think, you know, my man Chris, at this point, who's known me for a while, is like, cool, it's nothing. I've seen you do this. I've seen you do this. I've seen you do this. I know how you work. Like, cool. And if I didn't get it in those 2 days, on my own dime, I would have just made it up anyway. Like, you know. Mm-hmm. He's like, nah, man, we ain't got that kind of money, man. It's like, like, this is the budget. This is before Bieber, you know, was Bieber. Yeah. So it's like, yo, we ain't got that in the budget, man. We only got like $600 for your hotel room. I'm like, $600? Like, man, it's a closet in New York. What are you talking about? It's like, anyway, so he actually decided to, somebody decided to say, man, just pay the shit, man. Y'all look crazy. You know? And they paid the $1,300-$1,400 for the room, mm-hmm. For a couple of days. And that night, I remember going to the studio. And probably wrote Baby right before I went to dinner. It was probably like about 30, 40 minutes of work. Didn't take that long. I remember calling saying, oh yeah, I got it. And I remember my friend Scooter getting the record.
Scooter Braun.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Man, this record's hot. It's like, man, I can't wait to play it for Justin. And I heard that Justin didn't like it at first.
Real.
Which is not out of the norm for, you know, artists not to hear that, you know, record. So, I don't get it. Mm-hmm. But I think he's kind of glad he sung it at this point. But yeah.
I think so. A little bit.
Just a little bit. Yeah, they just put a thing out. I think once they added all of the content and stuff that they're gauging singles and stuff on now, like, it's the highest selling single of all time. It's crazy.
As far as selling viral just, hits,
yeah, every
streaming,
yeah, right,
all that shit.
Of all time, surpassing Elton John's Candle in the Wind.
Wow.
Yeah. I just got that email last week.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Shit.
It's pretty dope. Just goes to show you can have a hit in another way and then not be a number one. Umbrella, oh man, great story. So I wrote this record, of course. Evidently, I got so tired of being broke that I decided to write the biggest record of my life at that particular point in time. Mm-hmm. Every car company seemed to be making every type of car that I wanted. Every watch company was just screaming, please dream by me, look at this hoopla. And so I said, okay, nigga here now. So I get to the studio. It wasn't raining outside at all. Mm-hmm. Maybe in my mind it was, but I remember this loop being played at that time. And we were still, the trick actually was breaking down the studio, so we was kind of still putting it back together. So nothing really was working. Maybe just a mic and maybe some Logic stuff, which is a musical, you know, component of how it worked. Mm-hmm. Alongside Pro Tools. And there's this loop going on. Mm-hmm. That's pretty hot. I remember sitting on the sofa the same way I did Single Ladies. And at that time, it was a difference. It was different though, because even though Trick understood and respected what I did from a music standpoint, I had never been, like, how I would grow to be. Like, I was never like, yo, let me get that, which would be now. Like, I could just stop the whole shit. I could stop everything and say, going in the booth, and then this shit would happen, you know. But of course, that time was earned. But at this time, before I wrote Umbrella, it was more so, y'all good? Can I do my
go for it.
Do my thing? Mm. Oh no, I'm not talking.
Oh, my fault. I thought you was talking about the sidebar.
Yeah, I'm in the crowd. No. So I'm like, yo, can I do my thing? He's like, yo, go ahead. Of course, the mic work. Like, all right, cool. So I get in there and sing this song down in one pass. Other than certain words that I would go back and fill in or whatever. Like in one pass, Umbrella though, the skeleton and everything was there. Like, and they just built it off of that. I think the demo is online now, probably everywhere. But after the record was made, I immediately knew it was a smash. I was like, oh, I know exactly what this is. And this is when you add up all the time you've been working, like in the dark, shooting free throws forever. Like, oh yeah, we good. And we sent the record at the time, because of a relationship with Jive that Trick had, he sent the record over to Jive for Britney in mind. And for some reason, Britney didn't ever hear the record. But word had kind of got out about the record, like, oh man, this Umbrella record is crazy. And I think at the time, I think Chris Hicks had got it or intercepted it for Mary J. Blige. And at the same time, Jazzy Faye had called Karen Clark, which is now my great friend, and spoke about the record, like, y'all, you need to hear this record. These boys did a record, it's crazy. Once Karen heard the record, Karen would not stop calling. Like, she would call everybody like 3 a.m. in the morning, like 4 a.m. You probably could have got Karen to do anything at that point. Mm-hmm. You know, the things people do for hits. She knows the smash. She played for Jay Brown, and Jay Brown played for Tata. Tata was like, oh my god, it's crazy. Jay finally, of course, heard the record at some particular point, and then reheard the record. Reheard the record. They at the time, I think it was around Grammys that year in 2007, and so she just happened to be out there for the Grammys. And Mark Stewart, who's Tricky's brother and my manager at the time, took a plane out. And I was always, even up to that point, very anti with being in places that I didn't deserve to be. So I wasn't at the Grammys because I'm like, what the fuck, why am I at the Grammys? Like, I never believed in that. I never believed in going to the club if you ain't got no money to spend, or if you haven't made no money to be like, what the fuck you in here balling for? You ain't done shit. So I just stayed at the crib. And this is vicariously me living through all of these things after being told now by Rihanna and Mark and how things went down. Rihanna walks up to Mark and says, you got that record? He's like, yeah. He was like, I want that record. I'm recording that record. That record's my record. It's like, whoa, okay, bossy. And as soon as I heard that there was somebody speaking about a record I did at that time, and I already knew of Rihanna, you know, because of the first couple of songs that she had put out. So I already liked, you know, where she was going. I know at that particular time, the best thing for everybody, if you're in this business, you wanted to be on the bigger person, you know. But I was like, nah, I want that on Rihanna.